Role probably is more on what kind of technical capabilities do they have.
Or, cette base de données qui stocke, contrairement à ce qui est dit officiellement, donc des milliards de données et les conserve pendant des années, n'est pas simplement l'usage exclusif de la DGSE, qui, encore une fois, agit à l'extérieur. Mais il existe en France un système, ce qu'ils appellent, considèrent que cette base de données, qui est la plus importante en France, et qui est gérée par l'ordinateur aujourd'hui considéré comme le plus puissant en France, est également utilisée par les autres services de renseignement français, qui, eux, sont tenus par la loi française, et qui agissent au sein des frontières françaises. On ne sait pas encore, nous, en France, quelle est la réalité des accords qui existent entre les services de renseignement français et les principales compagnies de téléphone.
And any packet, any piece of data that flows through the United Kingdom goes into Tempora and it is stored for, as of the last time I've heard, at least 3 full days. So that's every single thing. It's not just metadata, all data. Right, so that kind of system, combined with something like PRISM, is a surveillance apparatus that the world has never seen before. Genie is just one of many programs for tactical exploitation. So that is to say that they want to know what it is that you're doing. And so they can't monitor you upstream, they can't go to Google to get your information, so they break into your computer system. And according to what the Washington Post has recently revealed, there are tens of thousands of systems which have been compromised by the NSA in an active way under just the Genie program. There are other programs like that that I'm familiar with, which have not yet been revealed in public, which will be revealed in good time, where they are targeting specific pieces of software, where they are targeting specific types of people, and where they are specifically doing it for people that are not terrorists. If we think about these systems as a whole, we actually have a planetary surveillance system that is not accountable to the people, that is used for extrajudicial assassination, in addition to other things. And one of the only hopes we have is to use encryption to change the way and to change the economic value of such interception. We can't stop people from spying, but we can lower the value of that spying.
This new thing in intelligence, which is placing mass populations, entire populations, under a form of surveillance. And that seems to me something that is new, hasn't been debated properly. It's something that everybody from the President of the United States down says has to be debated. There have been at least two instances where we violently disagree with the way that the law has tried to interfere with our reporting. One was the use of terror legislation to intercept and detain David Miranda, who was part of the team of people at The Guardian. And the other was the direct threat from the British government that they would use the law to prevent us from to either seek the return or the destruction of the material that we were looking at.